To give you tips session, I'm going to give you tips which is going to help you in order to get your website created at the minimum cost possible. And this is the website which is going to be most effective for you and is also going to gain business and also going to gain consumers or customers for you. So let's begin. First thing is, whenever you are having an idea of getting a website created, you want to create a website for your business. So make sure you choose a name which is going to represent your business. For example, if you are into gardening, you want to have a domain name which is based around gardening. You don't want to have a domain name which is related to trucks. So with that, what I mean is you want to have a website name which is gardening.com or bestgardener.com. You don't want to have a name such as besttruckdrivers.com. Okay, so you understand the difference what I'm trying to say. And other than that, just make sure the words which you choose should be 15 characters or less, and it should be also dictionary words. If you have dictionary words, chances are very high that your website is going to rank higher, and also it is going to be easy for your customers to remember your website. And that is what you want. You want your customer to reach to your website in the most easiest way. And that's only going to happen when you have dictionary words and you have a website's name which is short and precise. The next tip is that you should be buying a domain name for minimum of 2 to 5 years. Whenever you go to a domain name provider website, you usually see there is an offer for first year. You see that the domain name which you want to purchase, it is available only in, let's say, $1 for first year. And you buy it for first year. And then once you go for renewal, then it is going to cost you a lot. So it is always advisable whenever you want to buy a domain name, buy it for minimum of 2 to 5 years. Because website name is something which you want to have it for longer period of time. You don't want to have hassle of renewing your domain name every year on year. So this is one of the simplest tip which I have for you, that you should be buying a domain name for minimum of 2 to 5 years. And the biggest risk you carry if you buy a domain name only for a year is that you may end up forgetting the domain name, and in that year you might have grown up your business, and let's say if you forget to renew a domain name, you may end up losing the domain name, which is same like losing the whole identity of your business, because domain name is going to represent your business. Now the third thing is, whenever you go to buy a domain name on a domain name provider website, you also see they are promoting SSL. So you should never be buying SSL from there. There is already SSL providers which are providing SSL for free. So you can use Let's Encrypt. Let's Encrypt is an open source SSL service provider, and they are going to give you SSL for free. And also the renewal process of SSL is also going to be automatic. There are going to be scripts which you can schedule in order to get SSL renew once it is expired. So this is hassle free, this is free. You don't really need to pay even a single rupee in order to purchase SSL. And now, why we are even talking about SSL? The reason we are talking about SSL is that if your website is not running on secured protocol, then there is less chances that people are going to come to your website. Because nowadays, many browsers such as Chrome or other browsers also showing a warning whenever someone visits to a non-secure website. So what people think is that this website is not secure, and then they are not going to trust you a lot, because your website is basically a clear indication of how your business works. And if your website is having a warning that this is not secure, they probably assume or they have a kind of perception that your business itself is also not going to be secure. So just make sure you always have SSL and your website is running over HTTPS protocol. Now the next tip which I have for you is that you should be using Google Virtual Machine to host your website. The reason I am saying that is that if you sign up for Google as a new customer, then you are going to get $300 for using to create virtual machines on Google platform, and you can use this $300 up to almost 1 year. And what that means is that you can create many virtual machines on Google console or Google platform using this money. And the benefit of this is that if you host your website on Google virtual machine, you are going to have best resources and you are going to have zero downtime. And also what you are going to have is that you are going to have total control of that virtual machine. So for example, today you installed a software on that virtual machine. Tomorrow, if you don't want to install that software, you want to get rid of that software, it is very easy for you. It is same like working on your own system. So you can just log into that system and you can install the software which you need. You can use that server for web development and you can get your website up and running. And also that is going to give you more control in terms of housekeeping which you want to perform on that server. Now many of the website domain name provider also provide you the ability to host the website on their platform. But that really restricts you with the number of operations which you can perform, and also your ability to download or upload, and also the ability to let's say the amount of data you can store. For example, you'll be able to grow your total usage only up to let's say 10 GB or 20 GB, and if you want to go beyond that, it is going to cost you more money. But with this, if you sign up for Google, you are going to get $300, and that's going to be more than enough for you to really have a single website up and running with as much storage as you want. And as a beginner, I know your storage needs and probably the computing need is not going to be much, but this is going to be a money saver for you, and also going to make sure that your website runs in the most optimum manner. Now let's go to the next point, which is having a website framework which is having a rich community. So if you are not a coder, you don't want to build your website by coding on your own, in that case you can make use of website builder frameworks such as WordPress or Liferay, and these are the frameworks which is going to give you an option to configure your website without the need to code. Okay, so you don't really want to code a lot of stuff. There are people who have already done this for you in the past. Okay, so you just want to make use of the resources which are available. So I would recommend, as a beginner, if you want to get your website created, you should always be using WordPress. And the reason why I'm saying WordPress is that WordPress has so many themes available, and it also has so many plugins available that it is going to give you the ability to get all the features which you want in your website up and running as soon as possible. So with WordPress, you should be able to create your website in 1 week, and that also the website which is of enterprise standard. The next tip which I have for you is that your website should always be mobile friendly. Nowadays, more than 60% of the people who goes to a website actually uses a mobile phone in order to go to the website. Okay, so the usage of a desktop or a laptop has been decreasing. So what you want is that your website should be easy to open on mobile. Okay, so the another reason why I wanted you to use let's say WordPress is that using WordPress, the theme or whatever plugins which you use, all of those are mobile friendly. So this is going to work fantastic on your mobile. Okay, so you don't really need to bother about when you are building your website that whether it is going to run on mobile or not. Okay, so you don't have that hassle anymore. The next tip which I have for you is that if your website is having a feature which want to send a lot of emails, let's say you have lots of subscribers to your newsletters and you want to send an email to all of them, so the cheapest email service provider right now is Amazon SES. Okay, so Amazon Simple Email Service is a cost effective solution for if you have like huge demand of sending emails to your customers. Okay, so in that case you should be using Amazon SES, and it is going to save you lots and lots of money. You can check on Amazon website. SES as of now is the cheapest solution in terms of sending emails to your customers. Okay, so that's it in this video. I know in this video I have not talked about technical steps on how you are going to implement all of these things, but that's something which I don't want to do in this video. So we are going to do that in probably our upcoming sessions. In this session, we only wanted to understand what are the things which you should be knowing whenever you want your website up and running. Okay, so these are the things which you can explore on your own as well in more detail now. Okay, now once we are done with all of these things, the other most important thing which you don't want to forget is taking a regular backup of your website. Okay, now you have put so much effort on your website and your website has been, let's say, gaining lots of traffic. You don't want to end up losing all of those things. So make sure you run some sort of script which takes a regular backup of your website as well as the database which you are using for the website. Now, the other mistake which you don't want to do is you don't want to take the backup and keep the backup on the same server where your website is running. Okay, so you want to host or you want to keep that backup on some other server. Okay, so for that, probably what the best thing which you can do is you can use GitHub. So GitHub is having option to create one private repository. So using GitHub, you can take a regular backup of your website and you can keep that backup at periodic interval in GitHub, which is not going to cost you any money. Just make sure that you use private repository for this backup. You don't use public repository, because if you use public repository, in that case people will be able to download whatever you have uploaded on GitHub. Okay, so make sure you use private repository. And when you sign up for GitHub, you are going to have the ability to have one free private repository. It is not going to cost you any money. Okay, so these are the tips which I had for this session. We are going to connect in next session and then I'm going to give you few more tips in order to keep your website up and running in more effective way. And also we are going to discuss about what are the different ways which you can use in order to bring traffic to your website.